you please welcome the very funny Wil Anderson? Wil, congrats on the book. The book is called I Am Not Fine, Thanks. What specifically are you not fine about?
Well, everything. Like, yeah, I mean, that's a, like, if you look at the world, like, people ask you, how are you? And it's very hard to, in the old days, you would just say, I'm fine, thanks. Yeah. But these days, I can't say I'm fine, thanks, because, like, if someone said to me I'm fine in the year 2022, I'd be like, did you just wake up from a coma this afternoon and you haven't checked the news yet? How can you be fine? Like, climate change is a code red for humanity. COVID is not over, despite the fact that we're pretending it is. The billionaires who could do something about it are shooting penis-shaped rockets into space. and World War III has started and it's barely on the news most nights. And a comedian's in charge of the good guys. That's my the thing that disturbs me the most about that Ukraine story is that Zelensky, did you know this? Zelensky used to be a comedian, Michael.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
He was a comedian and he played the president of Ukraine on Ukrainian TV. And he was so convincing in that role that they made him the president of Ukraine. Like, that is like we looked at Blue Heelers and went, John Wood's really good at this. Let's make him the chief of police.
Well, speaking of penis-shaped rockets, we have been talking about Elon Musk taking over Twitter.
Mm-hmm. He's... I was really wondering where you were going with that.
I always go somewhere when I say that word. So Elon has said that he is helping humanity by taking over Twitter. How so not fine are you with that?
Well, I mean, I actually think he is helping humanity. At least he's helping me. I will say that because I have been looking for an excuse to get off Twitter. And this is finally the excuse, like Elon Musk buying it. This is the thing that reassures me. We look at these rich people and we think, oh, you know, if you're rich, you're a genius. And then you see Elon Musk tweet and you're like, you're not a genius. Like, he is the richest person on the planet and his joke was that he took a sink into Twitter and he said, like, everything but the kitchen sink. Like, let that sink in. That was it. Like he literally said to people, get me a sink, I've got this great joke. And no one in his inner circle went, no, Elon, that is a terrible, terrible joke.
On that basis, he will never be president of Ukraine. No.
That's right. But it's like these rich people have no one around them that they'll tell them that they're... That's the thing about the, you know, the Bezos penis-shaped rocket into space. You know that's got to be on purpose because everybody else saw that rocket. And everybody else was like, should we mention it to the boss? And no one was like, no, just let it go, let it go.
Is there anything you are okay with? If not fine, okay.
Oh, I mean, like, okay, well, no. I mean, everything is so bad at the moment, Hamish. This is the problem.
You've got a great life.
Do I?
I think so.
What do you know about my life? You know nothing about my life.
You host great TV shows.
You look at me, you're like, I have a great life. I stay inside all day long because I'm terrified of catching this disease that's going to debilitate me forever. This is the first time I've been out of the house for months because I came to visit you in a live studio audience where you've actually got people here in the studio. How am I? How is my life fine? This is not to be confused with Adam Hills. That's what's
I'm so sorry. Well, traditionally you have like a pun title, you know, philosophy, illogical, illegal. Why didn't you go with the pun title for the book this year?
Well, I here's what I will honestly say. I did not name the title of the book. So, like, normally with the pun titles, you'll know this, Michael. So the reason I have pun titles for the stand-up shows is that they ask you for the title of your show way before you've written the show, right? So you just give them a pun title. Like, because sometimes you call your comedy festival show something like 10 Important Lessons I Learned from My Dad, and then it's February and you're at the Adelaide Fringe and you're like, my dad only taught me 7 good things and now I have to pad out the rest of this hour. Whereas this book, I just gave it to the publishers and I said, I don't know what it's called. Like, you know, you just name it. Like, you'd call it whatever you want. And they said, we want to call it I'm Not Fine, Thanks. And I was like, oh, okay, is that... I should reread it. Am I okay?
Welfare check on Will.
Well, it is about, and I quote, enduring turbulent times with humour, community and just a dash of apple cider vinegar. What is the apple cider vinegar important for?
Okay, well, if you move to the northern rivers of New South Wales, 95% of the conversations you will have for the rest of your life will be about apple cider vinegar. There is no situation they cannot wedge a reference to that product into. They'll just be like, oh, you know what? right, you've got a little bit of a sore throat. What you need is some hot water and some apple cider vinegar. And I noticed some bird crap on your windscreen of your car. You know what'll get that off? Apple cider vinegar. Oh, and you're having a salad. You know what'll make a nice vinaigrette? Apple cider vinegar. And I see you've spilled some apple cider vinegar on your carpet. What you need to do to get that out is more apple cider vinegar. If they wanted people up there to get the vaccine, they should have changed the name to AstraZeneca to apple cider vinegar. People would have lined around the block to take it.
But also in the book, I hear there's a humiliating story about you meeting a former Prime Minister, Julia Gillard, yes, and embarrassing yourself. What happened there?
This is true. So my podcast, Philosophy, she was a guest on my podcast, Philosophy, and you know that emoji, you know how they say old people only use, like, five emojis or whatever? One of the ones that I use is, like, the yellow face with, like, the sunglasses.
Yep.
And
yeah,
does that mean cool?
Yeah, it means cool.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, yeah, right. Surely,
I hope so.
So I was sending it for
it's
ages.
Real cool, Will.
I was sending it for ages to my podcast producer, and then one day out of the blue, they were like, what does that mean? And I was like, oh, I thought it meant cool. And they said, oh, it reminded me of that picture of Tony Abbott when he was wearing those sunglasses that made him look like a... So I wrote cool on his head. And then every time I needed to say cool, I would just send that emoji. And then it became a running joke. So you know when you could put Zoom backgrounds? I used to have that as my Zoom background. So when I was going to interview Julia on the podcast, I was like, I've got to go in early, make sure that I've taken that down. And I did. And then when her call came through, somehow my computer reset and it popped up in the background and I literally slammed my computer shut and threw it across the room. Now, the throwing it across the room was unnecessary, but I felt like I needed to do it because I did not want the Prime Minister just to see Tony Abbott in the background with cool on top of his head.
Did you ever explain it to her?
No. I said the Wi-Fi dropped out. I don't know what happened. So she's watching. That's what happened, Julia.
She now knows the truth. Well, Will's new book, I Am Not Fine Things, will be available from Tuesday. Would you please thank Wil Anderson?
Because I thought you were going to tell me something and I was like, I've got to apologise to a lot of people.